ndzi twa nga ku ni ngo tlhelelisa ndhawu leswi a ri xiswona khale. Mabyanyi ma va ma ri koho na swiharhi hinkwaswo swi va swi hlangana na ntumbuluko. It is a very good feeling to be son of Induna or the upcoming Induna. It comes from the family. Yeah, just because my family is born here and my grandfather is born here. You need to know who you are so that the people can look at you as their next leader.
First of all, rangelands are important to the local communities in that they are the basis of their livelihoods, meaning that their livestock get their food from here, the community gets resources from here, such as firewood, such as medicinal plants and herbs.
Cattle are our assets, yes, but they are like our money, they are like everything.
Without healthy cattle, people cannot derive a livelihood.
Why not buy small car? You can sell in one, you get something to eat.
Over the last few years, we've started to see an increased acknowledgement that better management of rangelands and an increase of grass cover is a form of restoration.
It is so important to rotate cattle just because we can't keep on grazing on the same area. Grass need time to recover. So if not, you might end up having overgrazing. It's gonna start erosion and dongers and we'll mess up the whole area. So we've got the grazing plan that we are using here with the farmers. You need to make decisions together with the farmers because they are here every day. So we have sit down and then they all agreed. If we're looking at the rangeland, do we think we're going to need fodder? And these guys are like, Cliff, no, we're not buying any fodder this year, we saved. So we're so proud with that, yeah.
We do bush thinning and also brush packing. So the reason we're doing brush packing is to kind of counter the impacts of erosion and to encourage grass growth.
A lot of different farmers coming down to Dixie just for learning exchange. To see people from other communities coming down here to see, I think we're doing a very good job. If they look after our land, their land is going to be looking after their cattle.
Your cattle are happy, and you also are happy.
A lot of the things that I used to see, like flowers that I used to see, I didn't see them anymore. There were certain butterflies that I would see during Christmas time, especially, and those just suddenly disappeared, and I didn't understand why. Conservation agreements are contracts between local communities and conservation entities such as ourselves, Conservation South Africa, whereby communities commit to using their natural resources sustainably in exchange for certain benefits.
It's giving more knowledge to the farmers. It helps us to know that if we take care of our land in this way, we're going to benefit in this way. They do sign conservation agreement as well, just to show people as a leader that this thing is really working. So that's why this land is so special. We work for it and we want to make sure that it benefits us as the community members.
It's important for us to frame our understanding of their land from their perspective.
sites like Dixie on the edge of protected areas help to form a buffer and allow for those natural processes to move across those fences.
So you've got the Manyeleti to the north and the Sabi Sand to the south. These little pockets of biodiversity areas that we are conserving directly influence the protected areas. And so it's these sideshows that are going on that are important.
So there's that slogan that I like of saying that working together we can do more.
The only way we can effectively conserve nature is collectively, and we can't do it under strict regulations of protected areas alone.
The community of Dixie is a great example of how communities can contribute to OECMs and how communities can really contribute to conservation in general. A big reason why this will be a success story is that the community really has been entrenched in this project from the beginning.
It's something that it's inside my blood, and they say that. I don't even see myself living in the city. No. I will be here forever, and I'll see myself being here and to make sure that we keep this land for the next generation.